Okay, this is me, Conrad, again. I'm on my way right now to meet David at the job site with the excavator. And we're gonna cover up the dig job we have done over a week ago. And we have to wait for the inspector to come over and inspect the job. Then we cannot cover up immediately. And right after that, we have a lot of rains. Usually we don't want to go with the excavator and do with the dirt, work with the dirt when it's raining, because it's going to be just muddy. Then we have to wait for to dry out a little bit. That's where we're going right now. We're going out there right now to cover up the ditch. And I was not the one doing the work. Colt did. I have no problem to go out there and help out and cover up the ditch. Okay, I got on the job site. Me and David, actually. No, I was not here before. This is my first time. This is David with his truck. And this is truck number 23. He's got an excavator. David, can you show me? You have been here before, yes?
Yeah.
Can you show me what we're going to be doing?
Sure. Want to take a little stroll back here?
Yeah, I want to see exactly what we're doing. It's in the backyard, yes?
Yep.
Okay. And I also like to see the condition of it right now.
You're fixing to get a good bird's eye view.
Have you had a chance to talk with the customer yet while you were here earlier?
That's when we was going to get an excavator and we'd be back to cover the hole.
Okay, then we can take those caution tapes out. And
see what I was talking about, Mr. Conrad, when I said about roots and stuff?
Yeah, that's fine.
It's not gonna be clean dirt.
And it's okay. Mm-hmm. You know, we're gonna do the best we can. They still might gonna have to, if they would like to have a perfect job, they're gonna have to get a landscaping company. Then let's see what you guys did over here. Then we replaced the sewer line from the house. It looks like they had ABS coming out. We got mission coupling. We got a clean out. And we put the schedule 40 4-inch PVC line. You can see we have a lot of trees over here, and this is a new line right here. We got 45 around the tree. Hey, good morning. Yeah, thank you for having us. We got another clean out on the city site right here. Now, David, can you show me where we had that problem with electrical?
Yeah, right there.
Right there?
Right there where that white stub sticking up.
Oh, I got you. That's electrical?
Uh-huh.
Okay. How you doing, sir?
Nice day for doing this, I guess.
Yeah, we're going to cover it up, and we're going to try to do the best we can.
Sure,
thank
you.
To make it as...
This is Conrad, the guy I was telling you about.
Oh, yeah. Good to meet you.
Yeah, good to meet you,
truck,
too.
That's his twin.
Nice.
Yes,
well,
nice.
I'm working from home right now. I'm on a lot of phone calls, but you can text me or call me, and I'll come out if you need me.
Okay.
A lot of times I'm just in meetings these days. So.
Yeah, my office had told me you when we're gonna finish it up, you're gonna satisfy that bill today. Is that right?
Yes. Yeah, I can pay it.
And you're gonna pay with check, cash? What are you planning?
I think they said there's a discount for cash. Is that the same if you pay with check?
No, it's cash is cash.
Okay.
Check is check.
Okay.
Check is the standard price.
Gotcha. Okay. Yeah, I can go get the cash as long as you can give me a bill that I've paid it, you know?
Yeah, yeah. What we usually do, we send the bills via email,
mm-hmm.
and you got a copy of that bill.
Okay.
I'm going to collect your signature
yeah.
on our system, and that signature is going to be on the bill afterwards.
Cool.
And that bill has the pictures and everything attached to it.
Yeah, I'll have to go to the bank and get the cash, obviously.
Okay.
But what time do you think you'll be done about? Maybe a couple hours?
No, this is just a cover-up.
Okay.
I mean, I got easy access. Excavator is only unloading.
Good. Okay.
Probably no less than an hour.
Okay. Awesome. Great. Well, I'll go get it. I'll go to the bank in just a few minutes then and grab it.
Yeah. But overall, I know we have a hiccup with the electrical.
Yes.
And whatever happened, happened.
Mm-hmm.
Now, have you talked with that tree guy afterwards?
The guy that came out here, yes, he called me and we talked about it. I think what happened, and I'm not positive, but the guy from the city came out here and mugged the lines. It was very overgrown, as you can tell.
Yes.
I looked back here and saw some stuff, but I didn't see the lines running like perpendicular to the fence there. So I didn't see any marking there. Then, I'm assuming...
Have you had a chance to look over there before and seen the line? I mean... Because that's the whole thing. They said they did
mark it. No, let's go out there. They probably did mark it, I'm guessing.
Because right now they're saying they had to find us. And I was like, we didn't see anything. You didn't see anything.
I'm guessing that the guy came out and marked it, and then it got covered over by this, you know, debris. When the code 3 came and did the, you know, chopping down of all this brush that was back here. It was very overgrown.
Because right now we don't see any markings whatsoever.
Correct. I'm guessing it was, you know, buried by this stuff. He came through and did a lot of clearing after the guy came to market. So I couldn't swear to it, but I'm guessing that's what happened, you know. It was a lot of trees and little, you know, bushes and things like this.
Then my question is, have you spoke with that person afterwards? And did you ask him about those markings?
I didn't ask him about them. He said he didn't see anything back here. He called me, actually.
Okay, after we called him?
Mm-hmm,
Yeah, he was upset with us, too.
I'm sorry. Yeah. I just found him on Facebook. I don't know the guy personally, but he's like, I didn't see any markings. So, I think likely that's what happened is it was there chopping down all the stuff. He had like a bush hog type thing. You know, and we rolled over it. So,
I mean, it's easy to say, I didn't see anything. But what happened is we pulled a permit to get everything lined up.
Mm-hmm.
They come over here, mark the electrical lines.
Yeah.
They said they did. And then when we came over here, there was nothing here.
Mm-hmm.
We started digging, we hit the electrical line.
Yes.
And they come over and fix it. That's, you know, that's nice. They came over right away and get it fixed up.
Mm-hmm.
And we knew exactly what was going on.
Yeah, it's
but now they're saying, because you hit the line and we marked it, you're gonna have to get fined.
I see.
Because the rules are, if the markings are there, we cannot use any heavy equipment within 10 feet of the markings. This is why they want to fine us.
Mm-hmm.
Because we didn't see anything, we used the excavator, we hit the line.
Yeah.
Then I would like to see how this is going to play out. They did not even send us the bill yet. Then we'll see.
Okay. Yeah, let me know. I didn't see it back here myself, but I didn't come all the way back here to where it was.
Yeah, they say it's going to be around $3,000 to repair that line. I was like, I don't know, we'll see.
I actually have to go to Seattle in about 2 weeks. My job is moving me to Seattle, so I wanted to get this done first, you know.
You're moving permanently?
Yeah. I'm keeping the house. I'm renting it out, but I'm trying to get all the stuff done on it, you know.
Well, whatever we can help you out, let us know. I mean...
Yeah, I think I might have some more work for you, actually, just looking at the house. I've got, obviously, a crawl space under the house.
Did you sign up with our service program?
I did.
Okay, you know it comes with a free inspection.
Okay, cool. Yeah, they did say that.
I mean, you do have a free inspection. That means you just call, schedule the inspection. Yep. And what we're going to do, we're going to go over through the whole house.
Yeah.
And we're going to prepare the report.
Cool.
And if there's anything out there we find, we're going to talk about it.
Okay, that sounds
good.
Yeah.
If you have any concerns about anything out there as well, that's David's comment.
Yeah, thanks. My dad, I think, gave me your... In fact, he did. Told me about you guys. He met you some Chamber of Commerce or something. And I was looking for a plumber to kind of do this and then be on call. I'm going to rent the house out when I'm in Seattle, but need somebody to handle plumbing issues.
Well, you know, good luck in Seattle.
Thank you.
It's a different part of the country, completely. Yeah,
I'm not a big fan of it. I've been out there a lot for my job and they wanted to move out.
Don't mind me asking, what do you do for a living?
I work in video games. My company makes video games.
Then you do what my son wants to do.
Cool, I'm happy to talk to him. I work for a company called Bungie. And their best known game is Halo with Microsoft.
Definitely.
Microsoft owns that now. When they split with Microsoft kept Halo. So right now our big game is called Destiny, and that's it's a cool place to work. But they want me in person out there because COVID is ending, they say, and they want to open up the office in like November, you know. I got you. So yeah, it's a lot of fun. It's very creative. A lot of people in music and, you know, art and design and sound effects, and it's, you know, a lot of motion capture. People, I mean, put on suits.
If you have a job, like I enjoy my job.
Yeah.
Whatever I do, I mean, I love this kind of stuff.
Good, because I am.
If you enjoy your job, that's what matters. Yeah, if you have a job, you're supposed to enjoy it.
Yeah, it's work. But I work in IT essentially. So.
But yeah. This house, you've been here for how long?
15, almost 16 years.
Did you enjoy the house?
Yeah. It's been a great house, man.
And this is a great neighborhood. I used to live not far away from here, and I know this is a great area, close to Harbison.
Yes.
Shopping center. And yeah. You do everything.
My parents live on Lake Murray, so it's just, you know, 15 minutes away. Go see them, and then it's nice, close to the interstate. It's a quiet neighborhood, not too busy. You know, people don't drive through it to go anywhere. It's kind of closed. Saluda Shoals Park is right there. Yeah, I've been super happy with it. It's been a good place.
One more question I have for you.
Of course.
Overall experience with Colt. I mean, he worked on this job over here.
Good, yeah.
Then did he? He was good with communication about what's going to be done, how. I just want to make sure there's anything out there I can improve.
No, it was great. I think the only thing, they called and said they'd show up. They did show up, and so the communication was good. No issues with that. I got all these surveys, you know, that I haven't answered yet, because it was like, they came out, you know, I got a survey, came out again, got another survey. I'll just do that at the end. But yeah, no complaints.
I mean, it's supposed to bother you. Sometimes you don't have to do it. It's fine.
Yeah.
It's really up to you. I'm thinking we overdoing it, but at the same time, it's a risky, because sometimes people were not going to be 100% happy. They can say something bad. But you know what? Overall, we only get mostly positive feedback.
Yeah. Well, I saw you on Google, and we had a review on Google, and it's been a good experience. You know, had some other guys come out, and they couldn't show up when they said, and then we had scheduling problems, you know, and this was nice that they said, show up Friday, and you show up, you know.
Gotcha.
That's cool. I'll recommend you guys. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. If you need anything, just, you can knock on the door or text me or call me, because my job is a lot of phone calls. But I'm going to go to the bank and get the cash, and just the cash in an envelope is fine.
Yeah.
I need to sign for it.
Definitely.
Cool.
Definitely.
Okay. Good.
Yeah. I'm not going to knock to your door till I'm finished.
Okay.
And only if I'm going to hit the electrical line again.
I think it's, you know, right, it's right near the back here, right? So.
Yeah, but I'm not going to dig anything. I'm just going to move the dirt around. Then it's going to be a little bit different. I'm going to be fine.
So this was all little trees and scrub, you know, things before. It just, I was out of the country again before COVID, and it just became a jungle, you know, and then I came back.
Where did you went?
I actually, believe it or not, I went to Antarctica.
Oh, not many people go that.
Yeah, I had a contract job there for 6 months doing IT support.
Oh.
And with the U.S. government. And that was super cool, but I came back in March of last year. And, you know, the contract had ended. I was just going to get another job and then go back in last October. But because of COVID, it didn't happen, you know. So I had to get another job, and now I'm working for Seattle.
Talking about interesting people.
Well, it was a lot of fun. I had a great time. I was at a station called McMurdo Station. You had to fly to New Zealand, and then 5.5-hour flight down to the coast. So it wasn't super cold. I mean, it was cold, but it's like negative 30, you know, Fahrenheit.
Okay.
So in New York, it gets that cold, right?
Not from around here. We're going to get dirt from over there. But yes, I'm going to do that right now.
Yeah, so we only worked during the summer. I'll show you one photo. We only worked during the summer, and it was light the whole time. So midnight.
Oh, yeah, I can imagine.
100, the sun's, you know, right there. And, you know, we were on the coast, right? So ships came in. We had a ship offload and supply. And they just come in and give us all our supplies for the year on cargo boats, and then take off, you know.
But I'm surprised I don't see too much snow. I mean, I can see a lot of dirt.
Yeah. So we're in the summer, so it was probably about 20 degrees Fahrenheit, but it's volcanic rock, and because the sun's up 24 hours, the rock gets fairly warm, and so the snow kind of melts, you know.
And the penguins, of course, also.
They come up to you, and you know.
They're not afraid of people, really?
They really aren't. You can't approach them. You have to stay 20 feet away. But if they come up to you, it's fine. They don't even know what humans are. So they'll like come up to you and look at you.
Then who actually establishes the rules about approach to the wildlife?
Well, this is the U.S. Government through the National Science Foundation.
Did they have like a rules you have to obey? They give you to sign? It's like,
yeah, yeah, pretty much. I mean, it was a great place and a wonderful time. But yeah, it's all the federal government and then the National Science Foundation and then the U.S. Antarctic Program and then a bunch of contractors, you know, so people to do mechanical stuff, you know, fuels, internet, you know, IT, information technology, food, cooks and janitors and everything. So yeah, it was good.
I got you. Okay, we're gonna get started.
Awesome.
Yeah, good, thank you so much.
Good to meet you. I'm gonna go to the bank, get the money, and then I'll see you guys in an hour or something.
Yeah. Now I see when I see the job, I think we will be better off with the Bobcat, because we have a lot of dirt we have to move around.
Mm-hmm. Sure. Okay.
Okay. Well, awesome. We got an excavator. We'll see. Okay, I want to tell you guys something about this job. We marked the property we call A11 Dig, and when we come over on the property, it's a piece of plastic. This is the area where Colt was digging, and we hit the electrical line. There was no markings over here whatsoever, but there was some tree guy who was working over here prior. And you see all that mulch over here. Electrical company came and said they did mark this area over here where the electrical line was, but they said that whoever was working over here on the trees, they cover it up. And when we came to do the work, we didn't see any markings. And then we hit the electrical line, and now they're trying to find us $3,000 for the electrical repair, because we're not supposed to dig if it's marked. Now, we called the tree guy. He said he didn't see anything. You heard the customer. He didn't see anything. The electrical company came and said they did mark it. And I can actually see over here. You see there is a marking over here. You see that red marking here? I don't see anything in between. I mean, this has been, the markings were supposed to be put up like 2 weeks ago. And on this side, I don't see any markings whatsoever. But anyway, we're going to see what's going to happen. The electrical company said that we're going to get fined, and they're estimating it's going to cost us about $3,000. But what do you guys think? What you should do in this kind of situation? You come to the job. You ask for the you call for locate. You came in. There's no location. Now the contractor, the tree contractor, supposedly according to electrical company, he covered up the markings. Who's responsible for it? Then let me know in the comments. What do you think? Who's supposed to be responsible for something like that? Yeah, I understand if it's not marked. Electrical company is supposed to be responsible, but they said they marked it. Should we be responsible because we didn't conform where the marking is supposed to be at? Or that tree company is supposed to be responsible? Or no one is responsible? I mean, let me know in the comments. What do you think? Okay, I'm going to give you guys a little progress. Then I move some dirt around and I cover up the ditch. You can see the ditches right now covered up with the mini X. I just push some dirt in, and I want to show you guys the progress. This is on the back. That's the clean out on the city side. You can see how he drove over here with the excavator. I mean, the back is already done. I mean, it's the best I can get it done. I mean, you have to imagine, it's a red clay. It's very hard to do, but this is finished product right here. On this side, I'm gonna let David to finish it up, and he still has to move some dirt under the staircase to cover this up. Then I'm gonna wait for him to finish it up. What do you guys think? I mean, it is what it is. This yard over here is not flat. There's plenty of roots. If they would like to have ideal flat yard, perfectly manicured and finished, they have to hire a landscaping company to get this thing done this way. My job is to pretty much cover up the ditch, make it as best as possible I can. If you have any comments about it, please comment below. on the video. If you have not subscribed yet, subscribe, like this video, make a comment, you like it or you don't, and I'm gonna respond in your comments. Whatever you think. A question I have for you, for the community, if you're watching this, have you ever worked with the red clay? Have you ever worked at clay? Over here in Lexington, we have right now I'm like a Harbison area, Irma area, which most of the dirt over here is clay. On Lexington side, it's about 40% clay, 60% sand. Of course, with sand, it's easy to work. With regular dirt, it's also easy to work. With the clay, it's always a struggle, especially here, because you have so many roots, so many trees. And there were some bushes over here too. They were actually cleared up right before we start digging. Then let me know.
Hey, beautiful.
Davey, what do you think?
That's beautiful.
Okay, this right here, I mean, if you can get a little bit better, I got you a little bit of dirt on over here on the edge to for you to put,
yeah,
to shovel underneath.
The steps.
Yeah, then shovel that dirt underneath.
Yeah.
David is the man. Shovel down under the staircase and
yeah, that's all I was hoping you could do, was throw some up here for me.
Yeah, then when you're gonna finish it up, if you wanna get the run with the blade, you can, just to spread this out, or if you want, you can do this by hand. I know it's gonna be heavy, but come on. You're big man, you're strong man. Come on, show us how strong you are.
Yeah.
Big strong man, yeah.